We are delighted today to honor a man whose creative genius has given kids of all ages the opportunity to enjoy the computer animated movie experience. Today, we will honor with the 2,453rd star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame, John Lasseter. We have fans of yours from all over the world who are here. I know we've got someone from Tokyo, Brazil, and we have specially here today for you, first time, Mater and Lightning McQueen. John made his feature directorial debut in the 1995 movie Toy Story. And that was the first ever feature-length computer-animated film. Since then, he has gone on to direct, and let's hear it for the ones you like, A Bug's Life, Toy Story 2, and Cars. And he returned to the driver's seat this year directing Cars 2. And a very special note, today is the day that Disney releases Cars 2 on Blu-ray and DVD across North America. So all of you run out and get it.
So fitting that it's the day after Halloween, because last night when I was handing out candy at my house, so many of the children were dressed as the characters, John, that you have either directly created or inspired the creation of and nurtured the creation of. And what's so interesting is when the little kids come dressed up as one of the many Pixar characters, all the adults know the name of the character as much as the children do, and that so often doesn't happen. And I thought to myself, what's getting a star on the Walk of Fame all about? And it's something for me, being a kid from the Midwest, coming to Hollywood, you wanted to go there and see the star of someone who touched your life in a way you'll never forget with storytelling.
A man with a great sense of humor, a man with an awesome, obsessive attention to detail, a magician's knack for trickery, and a very big heart. And perhaps most importantly of all, a man who adores children and has a childlike imagination himself.
Sometimes acting doesn't have like a lot of blue-collar street cred, but for the years that I've been working on these movies, when friends ask what I'm doing, I'm able to say, I've just been working on Cars all day. So thank you for that, buddy, and congratulations.
John Lasseter is the greatest adventurer I've ever met. I'm so honored to be your friend. Thank you for bringing me along on your adventures, buddy.
I get asked quite a bit, how is it that you're the only actor that's been in every one of his movies? And I think it's about time I tell the true story. A long time ago, I used to make quite a good living tap dancing at state fairs. Just put on a sheet of plywood. I did okay. And one day, John and his kindergarten class came wandering through. John's much younger than I am, obviously. And one of the donkey carts caught loose, knocked over the funnel cake machine. And I got there just in time to grab John out of the way from being crushed by funnel cakes. And even then, he looked at me and said, "Mister, I don't know who you are, but someday I'm going to pay you back." The man kept his word.
On behalf of the City of Los Angeles, please accept this resolution.
I had this crazy idea to bring, is something I believe strongly in, that toys are alive when we're not around. And I developed this idea of a short film about a little tin toy who is trying to, he's being menaced by this baby monster. And so I pitched this whole story to Steve. And after it was all over, he loved it, and the only thing Steve Jobs ever asked of me was, "John, make it great." Tin Toy went on to be the first computer animated animation to ever win an Academy Award. And I shared that Oscar with Steve, and I said, Steve, is this great enough? And he said, yes. And so today, I share this star with Steve Jobs. And he made Pixar. Without him, Pixar wouldn't exist. Without him, all these amazing films wouldn't exist. And so I honor him today, too. So to my family, to all my colleagues at Pixar and Disney, to my best friends up here on the stage, and to Steve Jobs, we all thank you for this honor. It's the greatest honor you could give me. So thank you. City of Los Angeles and Hollywood Chamber of Commerce, you guys are fantastic. So thank you very much. I got a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame in front of the El Capitan Theater. I mean, that talk about, you know, the entire Hollywood Boulevard, I get in front of the theater that showed all of my films. That is so special, you know? What's so cool about the Hollywood Star is it's an award that is given to the public. You know, I mean, it's given to me, but the public can see it and come look at it. And I think that's so fun because now, you know, my children can come and see this, my grandchildren, my great-grandchildren, my great-great-grandchildren. You know, that's what's so special, you know? And I'm very honored. Now, one of the things that I love about my job the most is leading all these amazing artists at Pixar Animation Studios up in Emeryville and at Disney Animation Studios down here in Burbank. And I'm so excited to share this with everybody because it's kind of has my name on it, but it's really for everybody, too.
You're honored when you get a call from John saying, you know, could you come? I'm getting a star on the Walk of Fame, and would you be there for the dedication and speak? And yeah, John, I would do anything for John. He's a talented, inspiring, kind man, and I feel really lucky to know him and work with him and call him a friend. He has, you know, explored and heightened the soul of animation. He's brought it to a level that only his imagination can take us to, and then he nurtures that in other people's imagination that might think of things that he hasn't thought of. And that, you know, that's the real art of storytelling is to appreciate it in others as well. And John does that, and that's the joy of being around him and working with him, is because he'll finish his story and then he'll listen to yours. And it, you know, from that camaraderie and that respect becomes this incredible work process and working environment where the creativity overflows, and you know, that's remarkable. And that's why you go into this business in the first place, because you want that environment. I think the star means to John what it would mean to a kid sitting at home right now imagining what he might do with his life if he loved cartoons and wanted to tell stories and be an artist. I mean, John accomplished that, and he gets it. You know, he doesn't let go of that wonderment of, oh my gosh, could I? Is it possible? He believes it is. And that's what that star means to him, is that some kid's going to come and say, you know, when he's an adult, say, that's the guy that influenced me when I saw this, you know, animated feature.
He makes the world a better place, not only in movies, but by knowing him. He's one of those guys that everything he touches becomes more fun. It's really it's amazing to see a guy who's spent his life just making the world so much more enjoyable for everybody he's around. I don't think he's ever met a stranger, and John is the type that his life really mirrors the work that he does, because just like his movies are groundbreaking and they do things you don't expect, and they create worlds that are so colorful and so unique and fun, and his life is the same way. If you get to know him, he will put you somewhere you didn't expect. He will have you doing something that you never dreamed you would do, but you love it. And then you'll be in a situation where you feel like the world has changed in terms of your outlook a little bit by the time you spend a little time with him. He is a tried and true movie fan, first and foremost. He loves creativity. He loves being in the movie business. And he's not one of these people that's jaded or bitter or has anything but love for this town of Hollywood. And the fact that he's now on the Walk of Fame, I know, means so much to him, because I really believe that what he wants more than anything is to feel like he